We're going to talk about how we control access to resources. These are protected resources. Any program can make a request for such a resource, and we need to decide if the request should be allowed to go ahead, it should be granted, or we have to deny it. So we've been talking about the importance of the trusted computing base. In fact, when someone is asking for a resource, they are generating a reference for that. They have to reference the resource they are interested in or they want to use. So the trusted computing base has to act as a reference monitor. No request for a resource should go without the trusted computing base being involved in checking that request. Obviously, you'll have to see the source of the request is and what the target or what resource is being requested. And then we're going to discuss, so how do we decide if it should be granted? As a quick example, let's say John is a student in a class, and there's a file that has the grades of all the students who are enrolled in that class. John obviously can make a request to read that file. Not only he wants to see his own grade, maybe he's curious about how other people did on a certain test or an exam. So John could make a request to read a file. In this case, we not only have to monitor the request that is going to come from John, but our access control that we're going to do should decide that John should not be able to see other people's grades. So in this case, the result may be, you know, denying the request, but the idea here is that references have to be monitored, and then we have to make some sort of a decision when a request comes, whether it should go ahead or it should be denied. So we talked about authentication. Authentication basically tells us when an application or a process makes a request, on whose behalf that request is being made. So the example that we're just talking about, it's a process that John launched, then it is going to have John's user ID or UID. And authentication is how we know that this particular UID should be associated with the process. So authentication tells us about the source. Authorization or access control, which is the topic for this lesson, is going to answer the question knowing the source of a request. Authentication is going to tell us that. Once we know the source of a request, in this case a user ID, and the target of the request, which is a file, and what they want to do with this resource is read this file, should we let them do it or not? So access control is similar to what we have in real world. You want to access something and somebody has to decide, in this case the TCB or the reference monitor that is implemented by the TCB, whether that access is one that should be allowed to proceed or go forward or it should not. So let's quickly talk about how do we actually decide this. Resources that we have in the system, for example files, are created by certain users or subjects. You can perhaps think if Alice is creating a file, maybe she has the ability to decide who should be able to access it or not. The intuition here being it's her file, she chooses to decide who to share it with. So in many systems, actually, idea of an owner of a resource is defined. This is the subject who creates the resource, and it is at the discretion of the owner how that resource can be shared. There are other kind of systems where this may not be the case, and we're going to talk about that. For example, if you work for a company, the company may not allow you to sort of decide how you can share certain sensitive data about that company.